Welcome to Top 10 Archive. Arachnophobes beware. This installment is filled with creepy, crawly, eight-legged freaks, fanged critters that crawl menacingly over your furniture, trekking across your sleepy body when you're at your most vulnerable. These are the 10 deadliest spiders in the world, and they could be waiting for you in your shoes, in your cupboard, or even on the pillow upon which you rest your head. Number 10. Chinese bird tarantula. No, this isn't some sci-fi creation for a new series of B-horror movies. The Chinese bird tarantula is an incredibly large, venomous kind of spider indigenous to regions in China and Vietnam. Not to be confused with a Goliath bird-eating tarantula known for its massive size and appetite for aviation, the Chinese bird tarantula is a bit smaller, measuring about 60 millimeters or 2.4 inches long, with legs as long as 67 millimeters or 2.6 inches. Human interaction with the venom of this Asian tarantula remains mostly undocumented, but the minimal dose recorded to kill lab rats gives a good indication that the neurotoxin this species dishes out would, if left untreated, severely ruin your day and any plans you have for the future. Number 9. Wolf spider. Initially thought to have been a pack hunter, the wolf spider may not be the most dangerous arachnid out there, but its bite does pack a punch. Depending on region, both toxicity and size will vary, with wolf spiders found in South America proving to be among the most dangerous. Other regions may have to deal with mild itching, pain, and swelling. But anyone bitten by a South American wolf spider may face necrosis of the flesh, a painful effect that leads to dead tissue and a wound with an extended recovery period, but could turn into a deadly infection if left untreated. Number 8. Yellow sac spider. The aptly named yellow sac spider may be tiny, sizing in around 10 millimeters or 0.4 inches in length, and is about as dangerous as it is pretty. While this colorful species has yet to be connected with any human deaths, its venom is known to cause systemic reactions, including malaise, muscle cramps, nausea, and swelling around the bite. The bite of the yellow sac spider can even start off painless, but don't expect it to remain that way, especially if the effects of necrosis, a potential side effect of the venom, start to set in. The venom itself may not be deadly, but the onset of necrosis can lead to MRSA, a deadly infection with 20 to 50% mortality rate. Number 7. Fringed ornamental tarantula. Tarantulas are generally known for being fuzzy, terrifying arachnids, and the fringed ornamental tarantula only serves to support this claim. A massive leg span of 25 centimeters or 10 inches gives this Sri Lankan inhabitant its menacing look, but its appearance is not even the worst of it. The fringed ornamental tarantula has a bite you'll want to avoid, with venom that can lead to intense muscle cramping and pain. Despite its larger size, the ornamental tarantula can move rapidly, preferring to run rather than engage in a fight. Number 6. Six-eyed sand spider, Sicarius. It may be unusual to come into contact with this incredibly shy, six-eyed arachnid, but a quick bite from the six-eyed sand spider is going to register pretty high on the pain scale. Human envenoming is uncommon for this average-sized spider, which may explain a lack of anti-venom. But if bitten by this African critter, you could be facing a cocktail that leads to a breakdown of red blood cells and death of the tissues surrounding the bite. Even if the six-eyed sand spider's venom weren't lethal, the potential for severe infections of untreated or poorly treated wounds could be deadly. Number 5. Brown and Chilean recluse spiders. The brown and Chilean recluse spiders are a nasty pair, slinking around the darkest corners of a place you may feel the most comfortable, your own home. The milder of the two, the brown recluse, delivers a bite that is no picnic, often leading to necrosis or essentially the death of living cells. The grotesque wound, if not treated quickly, can spread, causing possible permanent damage and scarring. Not to be outdone, the Chilean recluse, regarded frequently as the most dangerous of the recluses, ups the ante. While there have been no deaths associated with a brown recluse bite, The Chilean venom is a bit more potent and can lead to possible hemoglobinuria and renal failure. Number 4. Lactrodectus, widow spiders. The black widow, brown widow, red-legged widow, and the redback. These four creepy crawlies are just a sample of the potentially dangerous Lactrodectus genus. All are believed to be venomous, though the brown, black, and redback are the three you're going to want to watch out for. When it comes to the commonly feared black widow, it's the female you'll need to watch out for, with a 1 millimeter or 0.04 inch long needle-like mouth. The brown and black widow share similar toxicology, with a venom that acts as a neurotoxin, though the black widow is considered more dangerous due to its more aggressive nature. Overall, deaths are rare, but the sensation of the bite is extremely unpleasant and can be fatal if left untreated. Number 3. Mouse spider. Hailing from the happiest place on Earth, Australia, the mouse spider, specifically the eastern mouse spider, may have a rather misleading name. You see, you may not want to snuggle up to one of these bulbous arachnids, else you'll wind up on the receiving end of one of the most painful things you may ever feel. Though not as aggressive as most entries on this list, the mouse spider has a venom quite similar to that of the runner-up deadliest spider. So similar, in fact, that the same anti-venom will work on both species. Luckily, mouse spiders are not often found in heavily populated areas, making chance encounters pretty rare. Number 2. Sydney funnelweb spider. Poor, poor Australia. The Sydney funnelweb spider spent several years as the Guinness Book of World Records deadliest spider before being knocked out by, well, you'll see. The funnelweb spider's larger size, up to 5 centimeters or 2 inches in body length and 7 centimeters or 2.7 inches in leg span, and often glossy black or dark brown body, gives it an appropriate menacing appearance. Made up of the deadly atracotoxin compound, the venom of the male funnelweb spider can cause symptoms within minutes of envenomation. Though an anti-venom was developed in 1981, the funnelweb spider still produces deadly results, as seen in the 2015 case of Josh Reynolds, who went into cardiac arrest and needed 4 vials of anti-venom to recover. Number 1. Brazilian wandering spider. Dubbed the deadliest spider by Guinness in 2010, the Brazilian wandering spider is an 8-legged monstrosity. With a leg span of up to 15 centimeters or 5.9 inches and a body length of up to 48 millimeters or 1.89 inches, this is no small foe easily dispatched by a shoe. Envenomation by this South American wonder may not always be fatal, but it comes with a fabulous array of possible byproducts, including lengthy, painful erections, impotence, loss of muscle control, paralysis, and a pain so intense that impotence is rendered the most desired side effect. Hey everyone, thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more videos like this, be sure to visit and sign up with our friends at Geek Fuel by using our affiliate link found in the description section. For just $20 a month, you'll receive at least $50 worth of geeky stuff that you'll actually use. Each box comes with a t-shirt you'll actually want to wear and a free Steam game download, usually valued at $10 or more. Don't miss out on this monthly box that Stan Lee himself endorses. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to keep updated on more lists like these, box openings, and giveaways.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I'm not going to Brazil anytime soon. You know, spiders can make my wife scream louder than I can.
Yeah, I'm...
Sorry.